Lucy's had a bad 24 hours. She had a pneumothorax yesterday, which means that her lung collapsed, and she had to be rushed up to the ICU. She got a chest tube overnight, and, you know, it's just been a bad 24 hours. Hey, Lucy. A bad night, huh? I'm sorry. How are you feeling now?
I'm having trouble breathing.
Is it just on the right side that it?
No, it's not sore. It's just I'm having trouble breathing.
I'm sorry, sweetie.
So here's our problem. Lucy's got an active infection. That infection has ruptured through the side of her lung and is leaking air and maybe pus into her chest. The thing that we're still trying to sort through and we're not sure is, should we take the lung out and hope that she heals up normally, knowing that Job's patients have a hard time with that? Or should we try to wait and see if it resolves on its own?
I'm sorry, I know. Things were looking so good a couple days ago.
Yeah.
So. We all hoped at this point she would be staying at the Children's Inn and about to go home, you know, and we did not expect her still to be in the hospital, still to be having this many problems. So it's frustrating and it's hard, and I think it's really hard for all of us, but most of all for the family.
We're really stuck here trying to sort out exactly which way to go. Do we go to surgery, which has its risks, or do we wait?
Despite progress in fighting her infection, Lucy's lung has collapsed. Now, her doctors are confronted with a difficult decision for which there is little precedent. They meet to decide the best course.
So now is the time to sort of put things in place and have a plan so that going forward, we can address things not in a reactive manner, but in a way that's semi-controlled.
So Alex, what do you think we need to do?
You know, I know transplant stuff is hard to predict and the inflammation tends to be in the area where they've had disease or whatever, but I feel like this thing is probably driving some of her problems. Do you go with surgery? Do you not do surgery? You know, I'm the one who's telling people around the world and publishing about trying to avoid surgery for these patients. And here I am saying, you know, I think it's time to do surgery for this patient. My gut feeling is that it is the right thing to do. Because we're not seeing inflammatory things in the other areas.
Potentially, the inflammation will never get better until we get to the root of the problem.
Anytime you have to have procedures, the risk of infection and other complications go up. So there's just a lot of uncertainty right now.
The question is, will it get better if we leave her alone?
Leave her alone, yeah.
I think we got a lot of issues going on here thinking about surgery. I'm in agreement that we're likely to need it sooner or later, but I'm nervous about doing it now. I think her wound healing is not gonna be good.
We have a decision to make, choosing an approach which might not end well and which has not been tried very often. It's tough.
The better she is going in, the better she is coming out. Yeah.
Faced with the unknown, Lucy's doctors decide on a cautious path. They will delay surgery for as long as possible so that Lucy's new immune system has a chance to grow.
We wouldn't be doing the research if we knew the answers to the questions. So this already puts the doctors in a very emotionally and sometimes psychologically and sometimes ethically difficult position, that they're straddling what they want to do to be able to answer the important research question and what they want to do to help this person that they're taking care of.
Hey, doctor.
I haven't seen you in civilian clothes in a while.
Yeah.
It's good to see.
With some early signs that the experimental trial has been a success, Bo Cooper is finally able to leave Building 10. He will return in a few days for a bone marrow biopsy that will determine if his leukemia is gone for good.
Stay warm this weekend. It's going to be cold. By our standards, it'll be cold this weekend. So I think the most important thing right now is to just get out of here and eat and get your strength back, not in the hospital. Stay out of trouble.
You betcha.
Take it easy. I mean, you're gonna be tired. You've kind of been through a war, right? All right, see you later.
All right, see you, Doc.
Leukemia mostly is a cancer that resides in the bone marrow, and so we're not gonna know for sure, you know, what the status of his leukemia is until we do the bone marrow biopsy next week. So we're at this phase in the protocol where we're just sort of watching and waiting.
All right, bye. Being discharged finally after 20 plus days. So obviously I'm stoked about that. I just pray and hope that the therapy is working, because that's what I need. That's what I need to work.
To see him walk out of here independently, one of the best feelings. Who knows what's to come, but he's a strong, strong man.
You in there, boy? I'm in.
All right.
So Lucy was having some pain today, but she hasn't, we don't know exactly when the lung collapsed again. The chest tube just is not keeping up with how quickly her lung is collapsing.
Lucy's lung has collapsed again, the second time in 2 days. Her doctors now have no choice but to surgically remove the damaged part of it.
We've had a lot of situations similar to this that have been really bad. And, you know, I know where it can go, and it's easy to mentally go there and think, how bad is this gonna get? Is it gonna get better?
We're all in agreement that we should send the children.
To ensure that Lucy gets the best possible care, she is being transferred to a nearby hospital that specializes in pediatric surgery.
The plan is to try to get her to Children's National tonight, and they'll go in an ambulance where she'll go straight to their ICU so that they can move more quickly to surgery.
Okay.
I'm scared about Lucy having the surgery, even though I think it's probably the right decision. You know, it's sending her to people that don't really know her. You know, we then don't get to be as involved. Could they stir up more infection by removing it? Is she not going to heal? Is she going to bleed? Could she survive the surgery?